A monumental decision. The city is considering what to do with four Confederate monuments that currently sit on public land. Some say they are offensive and need to be removed. Others claim they are history and must stay. WJZ's live outside City Hall. Megan McCorkle has more on the controversy. Megan?
Well, Vic, tonight a mayor's commission got an earful from both sides of that debate. They sit on public land across the city, but the fate of four Confederate monuments is still up in the air.
From my front porch, you can see the Lee and Jackson Monument.
Tonight, dozens of residents sound off to a special commission about what they think should happen to the controversial statues that some call offensive.
I think they should be moved to a museum for the purpose of education. I don't think that they should be destroyed.
Others, like Rosalind Hyde, descendant of a Civil War soldier, say they should remain.
I think those statues must stay where they are. They must represent the history of Maryland. They must represent the history of Baltimore, and they must represent the history of America.
The monuments being reviewed are the Roger B. Taney statue, the Confederate Soldiers and Sailors Monument, the Confederate Women's Memorial, and the Lee Jackson statue. The commission will make a recommendation to the mayor that could range anywhere from preservation to removal. The move comes as the University of Maryland votes to rename Byrd Stadium, and Baltimore City opts to change the name of Robert E. Lee Park. The city commission trying to get feedback on what residents want to see with the monuments.
Just getting a sense of where the city stands, where the residents stand on these issues.
So they can make an informed decision about the future of these landmarks. And the commission will hold a meeting to finalize their recommendations on January 14th. We're live at City Hall tonight. I'm Megan McCorkle, WJZ Eyewitness News.
Megan, thank you. And the special commission is made up of historical preservation and public arts experts.